Yeah, I'm Dr. Minish Jain. I'm medical oncologist at KM Hospital, Pune. We'll be discussing side effects of chemotherapy. Now, chemotherapy is a very important armamentarium of treating cancer. Whenever we are treating cancer, we have surgery, radiation, and chemotherapy. Now, newer agents like targeted therapies, then we have immunotherapies, all these things, but chemotherapy forms a basis. Most of the chemotherapy, 50% of chemotherapies can cause side effects which are either immediate or a little delayed, or they can be long lasting. Now, when we are looking at side effects, we are looking at some basic side effects. Basically, what happens is whenever we give chemotherapy, we are killing good and bad cells. When we are killing good and bad cells, we are killing their blood cells. So we get neutropenias, myelosuppressions, anemias, thrombocytopenia. So the blood counts drop. Then we are killing mucosal lining. So you get mucositis, diarrhea, constipation. We are killing their hair follicles. So the hair loss is there. Their eyebrows, eyelashes can go. So these kind of immediate side effects, which are very visual and they are not very lasting. Generally, once the chemo is over, most of these side effects will go away. The other side effects which can be serious is like change of taste, anorexia, means they don't like to eat, nausea, they feel distaste for food, they feel nauseated, vomiting. These are very, very important side effects because people don't eat, and once they don't eat, they become dehydrated, they become weak, and they do not recover, and they can't again take their treatment. So what we try and do is we take individually each side effect and explain them based on the drug to a patient. Supposing a patient is on a drug which is going to cause them vomiting, so we explain them what to eat. Means if somebody has got nausea, vomiting, that is a main side effect, then we'll tell them to change their diet. Change their diet in the sense, because their taste is gone, then we'll ask them to eat fried things, sweet things during the chemo for first 5 days. We may ask them to eat chocolates, take coffee, take cold things, ice creams, change to some nuts and those kind of things. So don't take regular food, or they may take soft food, they may take custards, puddings, those kind of things. If they are going to have, patients are going to have neuropathy, then we explain them how to hydrate themselves, make sure that if they get side effects like buttoning, unbuttoning, or if losing balance or losing chappals, then we ask them to inform us so that we can modify their drug dosaging. If somebody has got to have blood counts going low as a myelosuppression, then we either give them growth factors or inform them that if they get any of this kind of things where loose motion, fever, or any weakness, fatigue, then we ask them to get back to us, do the blood counts, give them growth factors, give them antibiotics. If their hemoglobin is dropping, then we use erythropoietin, we give them enough nutrition, we give them supports wherever possible. Like if platelets are going low, then we have drugs like romiplastine and others where we can push them. So there are certain side effects which are very, very rare, like, but they need to be mentioned, like chemo brain. Some patients who receive chemo, they may get mental fogging. Somebody may go into anxiety, depression. So we need to use sometimes anxiolytics, antidepressants. We need to make sure. And if you are using drugs like bleomycin, which can cause long-term side effects like cardiotoxicity, anthracyclines, like causing cardiotoxicity, nephrotoxicity with cisplatin. So this kind of individualized side effects also need to be explained to patient. Though these are all well managed, we have got very good drugs now. We have serotonin antagonist, we have dopamine antagonist, we have NK blockers. So nausea, vomiting, all these things can be very well blocked. Growth factors can get their blood counts up. Hydration, nutrition, enteral, parenteral can make patients eat well. Explaining them, having a psychologist explaining them, doctors explaining them, can reduce down their side effects significantly. Good antibiotics can take care of their infection. So with all this armamentarium, almost 90% of patients would manage their chemo very well. And my most important thing is, see, patients should get involved with their treatment. If they are involved with their treatment, if they are eating well, if they are drinking enough, if they are doing their exercise, most of these side effects can be managed by patient on their own. Very little side effects will require hospitalization or support. And with anticipation, like we know what is going to happen. So we prepare them day one, how to handle the side effects. And most of our patients would manage themselves very well. And always there are, this is an endless topic. So no matter what I try and explain you now, it is going to be, there will be some points which will be not managed in this video, but you can always refer back to the data available on the net, or you can get back to your doctor to understand it.